Well, Tom, just, I'm Diane Martinez. I'm the director of the Mackinac Art Center, and thank you for having me here today. Tom talked a little bit about our mission, but in a nutshell, it's to engage, enlighten, entertain, and enrich the cultural vitality of our community. What's interesting is actually about right now, it's been about almost exactly 1 year since we reopened, since after the renovation. And I thought that the board might be interested in knowing how are things going since we've been open with our new facilities, new strategy. I'm really pleased to share with you some of our progress. I'm looking at this slide and I'm having a conflict in my brain because my staff said, no, it's going to be more. And they actually did a event by event count, and we're anticipating to have 99,000 people walk through our doors by the end of the year based on the tickets that have already been sold and what we anticipate on pre-sales. We'll host about 261 events this year. To give you an idea of what that means, and when you read that at the bottom of that slide, two events a day and all of that, it gets a little wordy, but I thought I'd just give you a snapshot of what happened today and this month. This month has 28 days, as you know. The MAC has 46 performances in the month of February. Next month, we have 39 events. If you read in the rehearsals and the text, it comes out to about two and a half events per day with rehearsals, auditions, technical rehearsals, and all of that. To give you an idea of like a day in our life, today we had two school stage performances throughout this crazy cold day, one fire alarm pulled in the middle of a show, a master class and a lecture with the Visceral Arts Dance Company that's being led by our new director of the dance department, Jonathan Sloven, who's done a great job of getting Chicago artists out here. That's happening in the Playhouse right now as we speak. One performance for families is occurring right now in the Belushi Performance Hall of Shrek. And any moment now, our production manager is going to give birth to his first baby. So it's a little tense over there, and there's a lot of covering going on this weekend. The spaces that we manage over at the MAC is not just the Belushi Performance Hall, but the Playhouse Theater, the Studio Theater, the Cleve Kearney Art Gallery, and the Wings Art Gallery Studio, which is actually over in this building, as well as the new Lakeside Pavilion. So those are the spaces that we manage. Who we serve, I think there's sometimes a misconception that the MAC just does the commercial shows. And to give you an idea of what we really serve, if you look at the pie chart up there, in the upper right-hand corner represents the largest amount of shows that we support, and that's the academic shows. That's the music department, the dance department, the theater department's performances, and their recitals and their concerts. Then we do touring and commercial, and then we do rentals, and we're finding that rentals is a great way to help subsidize our events. We also do master classes for students. We host MAC chats prior to the shows with partnerships with faculty members who come over and help us with those. We have a new Global Flicks, which has increased to about 30% thanks to the wonderful Global Flicks collaboration between the MAC and the faculty and the Water Leaf. And we actually have international dinners before the films. We used to get about 40 to 80 people to a show. We're experiencing about 130 people to a movie, which is really exciting. The students also are providing dinners, lunches in their culinary department that go along with the films. We do about 12 gallery openings a year, and then of course our new summer series. All right, so how do we impact DuPage County and the district? We increase the livability of DuPage County. On an economic level, we fuel the local economy. According to the American for the Arts calculator, every person who goes to a show spends about $24.60 in addition to their ticket on restaurants, gas, child care, transportation, all the rest. So we bring about $1.9 million in ancillary revenue to this area, to the restaurants in the area, the bars, the gas stations, the parking places, all the things that people spend money on. Most people look at that and say that's low. So that's a conservative number. In 2014, just recently and now, the DuPage Community Foundation just concluded a study on all of the arts assets and cultural assets in the county. And I was really pleased when they told me, A lot of colleges were mentioned once or twice, but COD was mentioned time and time again, and is being recognized now as a central hub with accessibility for everyone and the promise to be a greater cultural focus for the county. So, how did we get to where we are, and what are we doing to stay there? We imposed a new marketing strategy. We're focusing more on television rather than newspapers. We're focusing on digital and social media. We have a brand new website that's really changed the way we interact with our clients. Our mailings are a lot more targeted and a lot bigger than they used to be. And we have an outside marketing and PR firm that is a professional theater-centric firm that really helps us to penetrate a very full marketplace. We've improved our service tremendously. We have 80 really amazing, engaged community volunteers who we just had our first celebration with this year, and a thank you party for them. It was really amazing. And we've stepped up their training. They're now trained in evacuation, health and safety issues for the theater. And there's a real sense of pride with our volunteers, and we could not do it without them. And I have to say, we couldn't do it without our staff. And when I tell you we do as many shows as we do, that's with one dedicated sound person that's an expert in sound, on-call lighting people that come in for every show, and a staff of about 13 that markets, promotes, coordinates, does the tech, does the box office, does the ticketing. It is a strong and mighty crew. We couldn't do it without our volunteers. We have a full service experience now. We have popcorn, we have candy for kids shows, we have a full service bar. For any of you in the entertainment business, you might not know if you're not in the entertainment business, 85% of the money generated for a show goes to the artist. You make your money in the last 15% of the house. So just like in the movies, you don't make your money on the movie, you make your money on the popcorn, you make your money on the pop, you make your money on all the ancillary. So expanding the concession area has been instrumental in helping us to reach our financial goals. We've really revamped the rental process and trying to get rentals in when we don't have a produce show to leverage that space and help us to break even. So how are we doing? Well, I'm pleased to tell you for the first time in years, the MAC is poised to exceed budget, which we're really proud about. See what else I have to tell you. We've modified planning and programming. For instance, the College Theater does a wonderful production of A Christmas Carol every year. It used to be called a college production. We put that into the Performing Arts Series because it's a wonderful tradition that the community loves. They had record-breaking sales this year. We've implemented strategies to increase student and community engagement. Added cultural arts fundraising focus. We now have someone on staff who helps us to raise money for the arts, specifically. And that's Janie Oldfield, who used to actually have my position years ago. So she brings a wealth of knowledge and understanding of what we do and the climate of fundraising, which has really been a wonderful addition. New Philharmonic has really experienced a wonderful surge of support through the community. They're meeting their fundraising goals, which we're very excited about. And we've created synergies between the MAC and WDCB Radio, the Waterleaf, the Inn at Water's Edge. And we also now do some classes with continuing education where they'll do a lecture with a faculty member, and then they come see the show, and it's like a class, and it's a wonderful outreach for the community. So those are the kinds of things we're doing. That has resulted in our subscriber base, which has increased from 433 subscribers last year to 750 subscribers this year. Now, you know most people don't go to the theater and subscribe on their own, so you can just double those numbers. Most of these subscriber packages are a minimum of two. Some are three, some are four, some are five, depending on the family that comes. We've really worked hard to engage students. When I got here, I did a survey to see how many students were coming to the MAC, and less than 1% were coming. We have created a program, thanks to the college's support, where we subsidize students to come to every show. Every show we hold 20 tickets at half price for the students. And I'm pleased to say so far 1,750 kids have come to see a show at the MAC. And that's growing, that's just so far this season. We also now offer $10 new fill tickets. 75 students came to see a classical concert, the last concert we had, which was just really exciting compared to like four, right? So it's really growing. We're working hard to continue to improve our programming to engage the student body. We did Colby Calais this year to kick off the season and sold it out. And I was told, well, they'll never come. Well, it's not true, they come. And we're excited to look at more programming to get students in the door. And I think that's the end of my part of this presentation. Thank you so much for the opportunity to present, and I hope, look forward to seeing you all at the MAC.
Deanna is a very exciting breath of fresh air for the college, and I think what's really nice is when you work in academia, people sometimes that are here resent you if you're not from academia. She brings together that private sector mentality. You can just see the know-how and expertise that she has in transforming the whole operation of MAC, and the numbers are really starting to show that. If you look back in 2008, the college had revenues about $1.6 million, expenses of $2.2 million. We had a loss of $616,000. That loss increased in the next year to $870,000. If you look at where we are today in FY14, we're now at a loss of $340,000. So slowly but surely, that loss is decreasing. In the 2014 and 2013 time frame, the MAC is only open for 6 months. That's when it was closed for renovation. So that's why you see the numbers kind of go off the trend there a little bit. Looking at the first 6 months of performance, FY15 over 14, you see that the MAC right now is almost at $1 million, slightly over $1 million for the first 6 months, and we've got a profit of $780,000. So congratulations, Diana and her team. They're doing a wonderful job. The MAC has a couple different product lines. I mean, Diana went through this with you, but the biggest product line is the MAC Touring. That's all the events we're bringing in the acts from outside. It's making about $180,000 through FY15 for the first 6 months. The New Philharmonic is the next big piece, and I'm a big supporter of the New Philharmonic, so I'm hoping that sometimes students will start to like classical music and bring that appreciation back. MAC operations, and then the MAC rental. MAC rental, hopefully the revenue should start increasing now with the renovations that were over there. And now we're going to talk a little bit about the